list of local priests credibly accused of sexual misconduct is out tonight. We knocked on the door of one of them, hear what he had to say about the claims.
The Archbishop of St. Paul in Minneapolis says tonight he hopes releasing this list will help restore trust in the church.
A judge ruled this list must be released. This comes as multiple cases have been filed against the church and priests accused of sexual misconduct. Our Beth McDonough's been looking into these names on the list, and she has more on this developing story. Beth?
Yeah, guys, this is a copy of the list. The release of this list, it is significant. It is the first time ever that these 30 names have been shared with the public. And while the disclosure answers an awful lot of questions, it raises others too.
The names of these 30 priests are private no more.
It's a big step in the right direction to helping keep kids safe.
Their identities outed: Dahlmeyer, Capone, Waymeyer, Kern, Vavra, to name a few. In some cases, there are faces to put with names. We know where they served, if they're alive. While the list is long of clergy accused of sexually abusing minors, the list of their victims is even longer.
Through the courage of survivors coming
These forward. Men, violated as teens, broke their silence in hopes others will too.
Try to put your hands around the idea that somebody has to force a religious organization to protect children. That's crazy.
The priest served in 92 local parishes. Some, like Golden Valley, New Prague, even Edina, had offenders serve there repeatedly. Of the 30 names revealed, 7 of them were surprises, never mentioned before in criminal charges or civil lawsuits. Also not in print, details of the allegations against each priest.
This is also an opportunity for this diocese, as well as Winona right now, to purge themselves of these scoundrels.
On its website and not taking questions, the Archbishop John Nienstedt said the publication is important for transparency, healing, the ongoing risk to children, and due process. He also announced a new disclosure policy.
Now, if the claim is credible and can be substantiated, our new disclosure policies will require that the claim be disclosed on our website.
The church says the list is not final. More names will be added over time, and that's because there is an outside firm reviewing clergy sex files. We also talked to the St. Paul Police Department today, and they told us the release does not change the way they investigate alleged crimes against priests. That investigations start when a victim reports a crime. If you would like to see the list for yourself, you can go to our website, kstc45.com.
Beth, thanks. You know, some of the men on that list are still living here in town. So today, we knocked on doors trying to track them down. In fact, our Ellen Gallis spoke with one of those former priests. She also talked with local Catholics about what they think.
All of the men on this list have been removed from the ministry. Some of them are no longer even alive. But others are still living quiet and, until today, somewhat anonymous lives around the metro. At this Columbia Heights bungalow, 70-year-old Joseph Pinkish answered the door.
Are you Joseph Pinkish?
Yes, but I have no comment.
Are you aware that you're listed on the
list? Yeah, I'm well aware of that.
Is there anything you'd like to say?
I have no comment. That's what I have to say. Thank you.
Pinkish hasn't been in ministry since 1992. But before that, he spent time at parishes in Hopkins, New Prague, Minneapolis, and Shieldsville, just south of the metro. He might be well aware he's on the Archdiocese list, but rank-and-file Catholics might be surprised to see who is listed and where they worked. Outside the Basilica in Minneapolis Thursday, Catholics reacted to the release of the list with a mixture of sadness, anger, and even hope.
They've been hiding things too long. It's good for the church.
They haven't been forthcoming. They haven't been honest with us. They haven't been transparent. And I would love to see the Archbishop go somewhere else.
Ellen Gallis, 45 TV.
Well, as for where all of those other men listed are now, some are still here in town. Others are living in other states. At least one is serving a prison sentence in St. Cloud for criminal sexual conduct and possession of child pornography. And today, Pope Francis is creating a panel to advise him on how to deal with clergy sexual abuse. That announcement came just this morning. This commission will focus on protecting children, better screening men for the priesthood, and helping victims who've already been abused. It is unknown if bishop accountability will be addressed by the commission. Victim advocates have denounced the Vatican's refusal to reprimand bishops who have shielded priests by moving them from parish to parish instead of contacting police. And we had a Catholic expert in studio earlier tonight. Later at 9:30, we're going to hear from University of St. Thomas legal professor Dr. Charles Reed. We ask if he thinks that we'll see changes at the top of the Archdiocese.
All right.